station by the river, sacks were being stacked on the platform. The men who had filled them had worked past, and they had not tied the sacks properly. As the porter lifted the last sack, the signal arm dropped with a clang. "Better hurry, here's Percy," the porter said, and he swung the heavy sack onto the pile, knocking the top one over. Several sacks toppled onto the railway line and split open. The oatmeal inside the sacks burst out, covering everything. The pouring rain quickly turned it into a sort of sticky soup. At that moment, Percy appeared. Percy wasn't going fast, but he couldn't prevent himself from plowing into the porridge which now covered the railway. He exclaimed and stopped. Porridge dripped from Percy's wheels, rods and frames. He felt awful, wet, sticky and cold. His driver and fireman got down to inspect the mess. "Oh dear," remarked the driver. "Well, Percy, you found out about porridge the hard way, haven't you? The thing is, you're supposed to eat it, not paddle in it." Percy didn't think it was funny.